Now, for the Attorney General, I watched. I know she has a tough job, but guess what? And I'm just, as long as we're being honest with it right now, nobody wants to hear from the White House or the Attorney General right now. No one wants to hear from the man who wanted the death penalty to come back from the Central Park Five. No one wants to hear from the man who says that the former president was not born in this country. No one wants to hear from the man who says there are very fine people on both sides. Do you understand what I'm saying? No one wants to hear from the person that they perceive as contributing to this situation, situations like this in this society. Not directly, but allowing people like that to think that they can get away from this. No one wants to hear from the birther in chief, from the sons of bitches calling person who says that athletes who are kneeling for this very reason, no one wants to hear from that. The justice system should work for everyone. The president of the United States, the attorney general of the United States should have the same system in place for everyone. That should be a given. You should not have to announce that at a press conference. And no one wants to hear that. Unless you're going to come out and say, I understand how African Americans feel in this country. I understand the mistakes that I have made with African Americans in this country. I understand that there is an election coming, but I don't just want your vote. I want you to understand that I know where you're coming from. We don't want to hear that. And that is the God's honest truth. So that was a misstep on her part. To come out and say, I want this to be investigated to the fullest extent of the law. We don't want to make any mistakes. Amen, sister. Amen, brother. But we don't want to hear all of that. Why don't you have the same urgency that you have for all of these people who are out there, who most of them protesting, but there are some who are out there who are actually ravaging and pillaging, or at least burning down stores. I don't know if it's by accident or what, or who are going in and raiding stores or what have you. Okay, fine, that should not happen. But what about the urgency for telling those people to calm down and we need peace? That same urgency when it comes to people who are being abused by the system, who are being abused by police officers, who are experiencing racism in this country and people are denying it. Where is that urgency? So I understand the anger of the people who are protesting, who are upset in Minneapolis, Minnesota. I am not condoning their actions. I don't understand the actions, but I do understand their anger when you feel you have nothing else, when you don't have a platform like a Don Lemon or a Wolf Blitzer or Laura Coates or anyone to protest, then what do? You act out in the way that you act out. Those people are upset. They are sick of it. And I would imagine people around the country are sick of it as well. Have that same urgency when you're telling people to calm down and don't be violent and don't go out and loot stores for racism and bigotry. Take the mask off. We are all fine. But once you get out of your box in the way that I deem that you should be, in the way that society is supposed to be, then we have a problem. Then I'm going to call police falsely on you. Then I'm going to do some sort of legal action against you because you have stepped out of your role. Well, these people who are out here now with the pictures up, they have stepped out of their role. Just like those people who were on the state houses saying, I want to get a haircut. I want to open up my business. I want to be able to carry a gun to the state house, loaded weapon. It is my right as an American. I'm fighting for my liberty. These people are fighting for their liberty. So if you can understand wanting a haircut, not wanting to wear a mask, wanting to go in a store and be able to cough on anyone, wanting to wear, in one instance, a Klan hood to a grocery store because you thought that was your mask to protect people from the coronavirus because you were so upset that you couldn't go to the store without a mask, then you should understand these people who are frustrated and who are protesting on the streets of Minneapolis, Minnesota, and in other parts of this country, because they are fighting, as an American just like you, for their liberty. Liberty is not just for white people. It is for black people. It is for Asian people. It is for all Americans, Hispanic, black, white, brown, yellow, all of us. It is for all Americans. So if you're gonna fight for your liberty, fight for these people's liberty as well.